Chapter 1124, Shaking the Plateau. Amitabha, Merciful Buddha. These powerful cultivators forcefully rushing into the portal were engulfed in a mighty and holy Buddhist voice, return from whence you came. Only the distinct ones are allowed entry to this door. Boom. This voice stopped and pushed away the powerful attacking figures all the way out of the Buddhist funeral plateau. After seeing the scene, many people trembled with fear. No one else tried to rush in any longer. One could imagine just how powerful the existences were inside the Buddhist kingdom after seeing the quick dispatch of the other big shots. They didn't even have the strength to fight back while being expelled from the plateau. The Buddhist kingdom has several high Buddhas outside of the Buddhist lord. A person murmured to himself while staring at the portal in the sky. Squeak. Mai Suyao and the other girls were attracted by the portal as well, but they heard the opening of a door and immediately turned back to see Li Kai leaving his room. The girls noticed that Li Kai had a very strange expression at this moment. It was indescribable. In short, Li Xuanyan, who had followed him the longest, had never seen this expression before. She didn't know what this demeanor represented and asked, "Young noble?" Seeing him like this made all of them feel uneasy. "Stay here." Li Kai glanced at the portal in the sky and issued an order before stepping into the air. Buzz. A path leading straight to the portal above the Nalanda temple was paved beneath his feet. "What's going on?" The girls were completely confused to see Li Kai heading in that direction. Mai Suyao murmured, "Something big is about to happen. A single misstep will lead to destruction." She was lost as well, but she knew the gravity of the situation. In the past, she had invited him to go to Nalanda, to the Buddhist kingdom, but he said no right away. Yet at this moment, he was going by himself. "Look over there, it's fiercest." A sharp-eyed fellow noticed Li Kai rising into the air over yonder. Today, the title fiercest deterred the entire world. All the powerful existences in the mortal emperor world were quite wary of him. He killed the mortal king, defeated Zanshi and heavenly emperor Lin as well as Lu Jikang Wudi. Was there any youth who still dared to compete with him? What is he doing? Does he want to seize the Buddhist fortune at the Buddhist kingdom? Someone muttered to themselves while watching things play out. A human expert excited claimed, "Fiercest is truly too bullish. He looks like he wants to challenge the entire plateau." At this moment, a large group wanted to see Fiercest going against the Buddhist funeral plateau. They yearned for a miracle where Fiercest defeated the plateau. In an instant, Li Kai entered Spirit Mountain and was only a short distance from Nalanda. "Benefactor, please return." While he was only one step away, the image of the eight-faced Radiant Bodhisattva appeared in a temple alongside a chant capable of converting the world itself. Radiant Bodhisattva. People were quite wary of this person. Even stronger cultivators didn't dare to come close. "Since I am now here, all of you have two options." Li Kai glanced at the Buddhist portal ahead with a glare that pierced into the depths of the Buddhist kingdom. "Either open the portal and let me in or I will smash this portal apart and flip over this land." His attitude was quite firm at this moment, leaving no room for negotiation. Each word carried a resounding and forceful momentum. Domineering enough. Both cultivators from the human race and the other races were lost in admiration. For many generations now, not too many people dared to challenge the plateau in such an arrogant manner. "What is going on?" Mai Suyao and the girls became more perplexed as the event unraveled. Mai Suyao was especially confused because Li Kai didn't seem to care about the Buddhist kingdom before. But now, he was trying to go there with an unshakable determination. Nothing could hinder his path. After staying near him for so long, the girls understood that their young noble was playing for real this time. Today, if anyone tried to stop him, he would surely slay them all and ruthlessly wash the plateau with blood. Amitabha, goodness, goodness. Radiant Bodhisattva seemed to know that he couldn't change Li Kai's mind and disappeared. Li Kai looked at the portal and boldly uttered, "Open the portal now or I will smash apart your Nalanda temple." The tone was flat, yet it carried a cold and ruthless intent filled with the urge to kill. Each word clearly displayed his determination. Amitabha, a loud chant came from Nalanda. This chant could convert the world while all the monks in the plateau prostrated. "You're courting death." With a cold aura, Li Kai directly stomped towards the portal. He wanted to forcefully climb to the kingdom. "Merciful Buddha." The chant soared to the sky from the Nalanda temple. A Buddhist light engulfed the nine heavens as one Buddha emerged after another. They formed a mudra of the word myriad and slammed it down to suppress Li Kai. "Merciful Buddha." All the monks at the plateau were prostrating. This surging Buddhist aura in the air made the world lose its colors. Li Kai's eyes turned cold. He shouted and summoned the heaven-sealing pentagate. His two hands lit up as he initiated an attack. Boom. The pentagate shattered the sky and destroyed all things. Five eternal creatures jumped out of the gate: sun-consuming bird, moon-eating wolf, star-devouring ant, heaven-shrouding eagle, and earth-sealing rat. All inhabitants of this world quivered after these five beasts rushed out. Everything was insignificant and wretched before them, not enough to reach the apex. They crushed the sky and immediately turned into five separate Grand Dao. Boom. The five Grand Dao combined to turn into an eternal corridor. This was a temporal corridor that could stop everything, including the erosion of time. Boom. The Buddhist word myriad that could suppress divine beings stopped before this long corridor. It couldn't move half a step closer. Pentadao Timeless Seal. This was the ultimate attack of the Pentagate. Under this eternal seal, even deities and Buddhas would have to halt their advance. Is that a heavenly annihilation? After sensing this ultimate attack, even cultivators millions of miles away trembled. Some paled and lost their minds. Li Kai crazily roared, "Open for me." The 13 palaces leaped into the sky. it immediately turned into a vast expanse. No one knew if the current or future Li Kai would come out of this new world. Nirvana heavens. At this time, Li Kai was holding a green lamp with a flickering black flame within. Hum, the three vessels all emerged. With a loud explosion, a boundless amount of blood, life, and creation energy all rushed forward to stop the power of the Buddhist funeral plateau. Even the plateau appeared to be insignificant in the face of this power. Anyone who tries to stop me today will die, whether they be Amitabha or Dishi. Li Kai roared. The green lamp opened and the dark flame immediately poured out into the sky. The sky was instantly incinerated by this dark flame. Myriad Dao turned into smoke. At this moment, regardless of whether one was true god or an emperor, even an immortal would turn into ashes. Merciful Buddha, a sacred Buddha that loomed in the sky, wanted to counter against this terrifying flame. However, his scream was the only result. He was rendered into cinders before one could even blink. Stop me and die. Li Kai's voice resounded across the nine firmaments. The declivity mountain bell in his hand unleashed a blow. Boom. The ultimate attack, a heavenly annihilation, appeared before this world. Divine Mount Meru. A mountain protected by deities and Buddhas emerged from its attack. Nothing could stop its momentum. Bang. The entire plateau quaked like a tiny boat in the midst of a torrential storm. Crack. Even the strongest portal protecting the Buddhist kingdom began to crack in the face of this paramount strike. Countless people were forced down to their knees. Even paragons and god monarchs were trembling with fear. They felt that they were merely ants. This is his true power, a power capable of slaying god kings. Everyone was aghast. They understood that Li Kai's previous bouts were only warm-ups. He was just casually playing around. How could he be so invincible? Gods and Buddhas will all be annihilated. A pale paragon couldn't get up from his kneeling posture. Those are only avatars. The Buddhas and Nalanta still haven't come out yet. Regardless, I'm afraid the Buddhas might be severely wounded from such an attack. A god monarch was quite discerning and explained despite being horrified.